Hi, I'm Patrick, and this is what's new for the Edge developer tools in version 107. In version 107, in focus mode, the activity bar icons now also show text labels on mouse over. The keyboard shortcut for the command palette experiment was changed to Control Q or Command Q on Mac. The memory tool can now load larger heap snapshot files. Links in the application tool now render correctly even when using a high contrast mode. You can choose if DevTools searches as you type or not. And finally, Playwright can be used to automate the Microsoft Edge WebView 2 control. So let's dive in. First, in focus mode, which is our new experimental user interface for DevTools, when the text labels are not visible in the activity bar, the names of the tools now appear on mouse over. You can place the activity bar vertically to the side of DevTools to save space, and when they're in this orientation, only the icons are shown for the tools. Starting with Edge 107, the names of the tools now appear immediately as you move your mouse over the tools icons. This makes it faster and easier to find the tools you're looking for and switch between them. Next, we're changing the keyboard shortcut for the Command Palette experiment. In Microsoft Edge 106, we had introduced Command Palette, which is this experimental feature to quickly access browser management features as well as developer tools. And in version 107, the keyboard shortcut to open the Command Palette has been changed to Control Q or Command Q on Mac. The old shortcut conflicted for some people with other popular software. As a reminder, if you want to try the Command Palette today, go to Edge Flags, type Command Palette, enable the feature, and restart the browser. Then press Ctrl Q and start typing to find useful commands. Next, in the memory tool, you can now load much larger heap snapshot files. The memory tool allows you to capture the full memory that the web page uses and even store this capture as a file on your disk and then share it with others. In previous versions, trying to load a very large heap snapshot file again in the memory tool would sometimes result in an error message and the snapshot would just simply not be loaded. In version 107, this bug has been fixed and you can now load much larger heap snapshot files. This issue was caused by a hard-coded limit in V8, which is the JavaScript engine of the browser. We've now fixed that bug, but if you still encounter problems when loading heap snapshot files in the memory tool, please file an issue on our repository at github.com/microsoftedge/devtools. Moving on, as you know, we continuously improve the accessibility of our products, and this includes the Microsoft Edge DevTools. We recently received reports about the application tool not behaving correctly when using a high contrast mode on Windows. The links in the application tools were not visible and they didn't match the colors set in the high contrast setting. Now this bug has been fixed, all the links are visible and they correctly match the settings that you've made in the high contrast mode. Next, it's now possible to choose whether you want DevTools to search as you type or not. Previously, when searching in DevTools, for example, in the Elements tool, the results would appear as you type. This can be very useful and make it faster to find results, but it can also become a problem if you're using longer queries, because the DOM elements in the Elements tool would scroll up and down as you're typing the search terms. You can now disable this search as you type feature by going into the settings, then scrolling down to the global settings and unchecking the search as you type feature. Now the results are only shown after you press enter. And finally, Playwright can now automate WebView 2. Playwright is a testing library that enables reliable end-to-end testing across browsers and platforms. And Playwright has always supported Microsoft Edge, but now Playwright also supports testing and automating the WebView 2 control embedded in a native application. To get started, refer to Playwright's documentation at playwright.dev/docs/webview2. And here's a little DevTools tip for you before we wrap this up. In DevTools, you can actually customize the DevTools keyboard shortcuts. There are many shortcuts in DevTools to perform actions and tasks more easily or more quickly, and you can see the entire list by going into the settings, by pressing F1, and then clicking the shortcuts item in the sidebar. If you want to change any of the existing shortcuts, just click on the edit button next to it, press the new key combination that you want to use, and save the new shortcut. And that's it for today. If you have ideas, feature requests or bugs that you want to discuss with us, please send us an issue on github.com/microsoftedge/devtools. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at msedgedev and like and subscribe if you want to stay tuned for what's coming next in version 108.